What is it that we have to do to change this world? What can I do? What can you do?
Sitting at home, all alone, just watching my TV. The news comes on, the world's gone wrong, that's how it seems to me. See people dying, people crying, got no food to eat. It ain't my life, so tell me why it means so much to me. Let's try to open our hearts. It's not too late to make a prayer.
Hi mga kasilip, welcome back sa ating panibagong vlog, ang tinatawag nating Moto Charity Vlog Part 2. So in today's vlog ay nandito tayo ngayon sa bahay ng ating kaibigan, ang mag-asawang napakabait mga kasilip. Naimbitahan tayo pumunta dito kasi nga daw magbibigay sila donation sa ating mga kapwa nangangailangan. So tara, excited na ako, pasukin na natin ang bahay nila. Let's go! Hi, sir.
Welcome to my home, Zach.
Hi.
Hello.
How are you?
Oh,
I'm good.
I'm fine.
Hi, Maam.
I'm fine. Please?
Hi, Maam.
How are you?
I'm good. Ikaw, Maam, how are you?
Okay lang. Come inside.
So, yun mga kasilip, nandito na tayo sa bahay ng ating kaibigan na mag-asawang napakabait. Yun, parati sila nagbibigay ng tulong sa mga kapwa natin nangangailangan. So, before ko sila i-introduce, let me share you something. Sila ay member din ng Raita Iloilo. Nag-post sila last time sa social media na magbibigay daw sila tulong ng sa mga kapwa din rider. So, ako isa sa mga pinalad at nabigyan din nila ng tulong na nabigyan nila ng riding pants. So, yung iba ay nabigyan nila ng helmet, gloves. So, yun. I would like to thank Mr. Eirik, Johannesen, and Maam Marvie.
Thank you.
So, sila napakamabait nating sponsor for today sa ating vlog. Sir, how are you?
Salamat. I am very good. Thank you, sir.
Writer din po si Sir. And Maam, she is the lovely wife of Sir Eirik. Kilalanin natin sila mga kasilip. We'll ask them a few questions. Okay, sir, can I ask you a few questions?
Yeah, of course, yeah.
So, sir, this question goes out for you. What do you like about Filipinos, sir?
Oh my God, I hope you have a lot of memory card because it's so much. First of all, I really love the people. And the way you are against each other, it appealed to me. And it's like you are good people. it's very difficult to explain because before I come to the Philippines, I lived 30 years in Thailand and worked there. That is a very different culture. But when I come back to the Philippines because that's what I think it was. Yeah. It's like you come back to westernized culture. Okay. More common sense, more logic. You speak all the language. In Thailand, when I worked there, I needed to speak Thai and Laos. I learned that all over the years. So to come to the Philippines, it was like a big relief for me. So I decided that here I want to try to retire myself because I like not everything, but I like so much about the Philippines. You have a good country, you know.
Thank you for that, sir.
I understand why MacArthur say I will return.
So this question goes out for you, number two question. What made you guys decide to donate or share some blessings to others?
Oh, okay. Well, when you know we ride around and you see what's happening in these COVID times, You see people losing their job, they're suffering, they have no food, everything. And I cannot ride around and see, look at that without it affecting me. So you see hungry children, you see a father lose his job, his car, his bike, his house,
yeah,
and his wife. So that's a very, very strong emotional feeling for me. So, and so I have a little bit extra, so why don't I just share it? Like, I have so many things that's very difficult to sell. So a very good friend of mine, a Norwegian that live here in Iloilo, he told me, if you can't sell it, give it away. And then, wow, yes, there the idea was born. So I'm pretty sure many people know who is. He's a dwarfism, a very short little guy. That he lived in Norwegian, lived in Iloilo for 20 years at least.
More,
yeah,
than?
More than 20 years, yeah.
Okay.
So he guided me into it. And I felt it was something that missing, and now I feel that was the right thing to do. So that's why I was, you know, why not just start and do it? And the thing is that what was very important for me, that I give it away to people for the right cause. To people that don't want to take advantage of me because I'm a foreigner and yeah, things of that. So that's why I want to talk with them in person, like you came here and said, to choose the people I want to give it to. But the problem is, all of them were so nice. So, yeah, so I couldn't send them home without nothing. So then I tell Bim, her nickname, yeah, to, can you just call Kirby in Santa Barbara and just make sure you have a helmet in every size, and then we buy five more helmets.
Four to
the other guys that didn't even have my LS2 helmet. So then it was rolling, you know. So I say that's how it started, and then I saw your blog.
Yeah.
And I think that's Zach. SILIP. And I was like thinking, for me to buy a motorbike full of jewelry, it's not that very much.
Yeah.
So I think, why not do it again? And then we talked and get agree how we're going to do it, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Si Ma'am, siya isa sa nag-message sa akin nga to come here sa Ilabalay and invite me para to share the blessings para sa mga kapwa tanganaga kailan lang. Ma'am, si Ma'am Marvie na siya makabuot.
I'm very shy.
Yeah, that's okay. Don't worry about that thing. You look cute. You look beautiful.
So, sir, third question, last question, sir. Sir, how long have you been here in the Philippines?
I come here July
2017.
So, 4 years. 4 years. So, I come to Antique. San Jose, Funda Dalipe, and I went to that bungalow. So I was, because of all, I was retired. I come to my new retirement, so I just want to relax. In a very weird way, she come into my life. And she didn't trust a foreigner, I didn't trust Asian, no, not Filipino, but because of bad experience before in my life. So she was working as a caretaker for an old lady in Manila. and or MCR in the Manila region, and we was just start talking on Messenger and everything in that way. So I was testing her really hard for what this girl, what kind of girl are this, you know? And then you had the long story, and we agreed that she will take an airplane to Iloilo City and meet me on one condition. We go to her parents' house and meet her. So we did. She take the airplane to Iloilo. I need to go from Antique with minivan and these crazy drivers. They're like, you're scared for your life. So, okay. So we come to, I come to Iloilo, and a lot of things happened there. And I felt that, you know, that big relief. Yeah. First time I met her. And I sitting there with her mom and pop, I didn't know what to say, I didn't know what to do, you know, that stress, you know, it was surrealistic, it was crazy, you know, or everything. And then I had to go through 4 hours of hell to get to the house up in the mountain. Jeez, and it was raining, even 4x4 couldn't take us up in the mountain. It was an experience I never forget in my life. It was a journey, and you know, I loved every second of it. Wow. After that, we like soul friends. It's like we bond together. Yeah. For the rest of my life. So actually, it's one of the most happiest moments in my life. It was so nice. So we had 4 year anniversary here, 10th of September, yeah, that they celebrated with some good pizza, and your mama papa was coming here. They're my best friend, mama papa.
Wow.
Yeah, I love them. It's like, when is mama papa coming? Where is my, they're so, it's, we have so fun, much fun when they're coming here. We're watching movies, and we just have so much fun. It's like a real family, you know, good connection and everything. So, well, that is how I met them. Yeah.
Two lovely couples.
Yeah, two happy.
Yeah, happy and lovely couples.
Yeah. What's that?
So may advice si Sir Satin. So what's your advice to our fellow riders, sir?
Well, when you go out and ride, the most important you need is your helmet.
Okay.
Then knee protection and proper boots.
Wow, what's that?
With boots, you steer your bike, because that you use all the time. And the first thing, if you fall down, it's your leg and knees that will be hit. So boots, knee protection, and helmet. And if you don't have a jacket, use some elbow protection. Then you will be fine. If you don't die crazy and go in 150, then you're finished and you can drive naked, you know. So, so boots and helmet is the number one thing for riding. You don't ride in slippers.
Yeah.
You don't ride in slippers, yeah?
So, ito yung bike ni sir. Sir Eirik. Versus 650.
Wow.
Yeah. This is my mistress. No. This is my wife.
Napakaganda, ha?
This is what we have for now. If you're not watching TV, we are out riding. So, it's better than TV.
Okay, thank you, sir. So yun mga kasilip, nakuha na natin ang donation ng ating sponsor, and marami na naman tayong mapapangiti ngayong araw na to sa pera na to. And so kailangan ko ng backup, nakita ko ang aking partner na si BJ. So siyang nakita ko sa daan na maging partner ko ngayon kasi hindi ko alam po na hindi ko kakayanin ng mag-isa lang ako. So yun, nandito kami sa Jollibee ngayon. Nag-order na kami ng food for 40 packs. So yun.
40 packs, let's go!
Yeah! Wow! So yun mga kasilip, nandito tayo sa Festive Mall Jollibee. So thank you sa mga staff ng Festive Mall Jollibee for accommodating us sa mga orders natin. So yun, sila sir, ma'am, ano mo sasabi nyo?
Sir, you can visit us at Jollibee Festive Mall.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
More power sa Jollibee. So yun, nakuha na namin ang mga order. So ito, 40 packs. Kaso medyo umuulan. Pero ulan lang yan. And gusto namin makapagbigay ng saya sa mga nagugutom. So yun, mga kasilip. Okay, bye-bye.
Mabuhay.
Take out the knife. Take out the knife. Oh my, how? Oh my, how?
Thank you.
Oh, oh. Ataglas ang Ginoo.
Ang Ginoo, daw pa to, tao. May kabataan to. Tagae na, tagae. Tagae.
Pamahaw!
God bless.
So, yung mga kasilip, gusto namin sana umakyat sa taas. Mas marami pa daw doon na mga kabataan at nagbabasura. So, umuulan ngayon, masama ang panahon. Maputik daw doon, mahirap. So, plano namin is bumalik na lang kami, babalikan na lang namin sila ulit. Sip, be. Bebe. Oo, at ang Ginoo na. Okay, thank you ah. Pumahaw na ka mo na, wake niyo ulit lahat. Pumahaw ka mo hindi. Tulad pala, TikTok na ya. Kaysa lang, TikTok. Ano balagyan nyo? Singgit lang mayo, be. Para sa inyo na, mga kumuha. Ah, bye-bye na yung vlog ko. Bye-bye. May Facebook ka mo? Dali lang. Ulan, umuulan. Medyo marami-rami pa to. So, papunta kami ngayon sa Mulie. Maghanap tayo doon na pwede natin mapagbibigyan ng merienda. Okay?
Kaya ba? Kaya. Ha? Ready? Kaya.
brand new start. Even now, I believe there are solutions to the problems we see. We should all take a chance. Don't be afraid to lend a helping hand. This world could be so beautiful if we just work together to make a difference today. Boy, kamu kan mas tau. Selalu di hari-hari aku mau. La 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 la. Open up your eyes, don't you realize they need you? Let's not run away. Listen when I say that I believe. If we just open our hearts, it's not too late to make a brand new start. Even now, I believe there are solutions to the problems we see. Bata lang ha, bata. Nagaling kami ito. Kaging dumog kami ito. Okay, anong galon mo? Okay. Seems to me, see people dying, people crying, got no food to eat. It ain't my life, so tell me why it means so much to me. Let's try to open our hearts. It's not too late to make a brand new start. Here and now, I believe there are solutions to the problems we see. We should all take a chance. Don't be afraid to lend a helping hand. This world could be so beautiful if we just work together to make a difference today. La 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 la.